There will be no extension of the filing of statements of contribution and expenditures due today, except for winning candidates and partidist groups. Commission on Elections Director for Education and Information, James Jimenez, says those who won in the May elections may have until 6 months for late filing. Jimenez reminds candidates that habitual failure to submit their SOSE could also result in disqualification from holding public office. He also denies media are restricted from accessing the SOSE documents.
In fact, media is getting a lot of information. I don't know where that's coming from. Ano naghihigpit sa media. When in fact, wala pang official announcement ang COMELEC, nire-report na sa media yung SOSE. So anong paghihigpit ang nagaganap? We want also that there will be a final release of information kapag umabot na yung deadline. Para walang masabi na nagpe-pressure tayo ng iba na, uy, bakit si ano nag-file na, ikaw hindi pa. Para maiwasan lang yon.
Vice President-elect Sara Duterte Carpio spent more than 216 million pesos for her campaign. Like her presidential running mate Bongbong Marcos, all her expenses were covered by contributions. Over 136 million pesos came from her political party, while over 79 million was donated by other sources. Duterte Carpio filed her statement of contributions and expenditures Tuesday, a day shy of Wednesday's deadline. Manila Mayor Isko Moreno has also submitted his SOSE. The losing presidential candidate spent over 242 million pesos for his campaign, but he only used 1.1 million pesos from his personal finances, as most of the funds were donated. The Interior Department has warned candidates winners will not be allowed to assume office if they fail to file their SOSEs today. President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. set to attend the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation, or APEC, summit in Thailand this November. The Marcos camp said he was personally invited by Thailand's chargé d'affaires. The high-level regional event will be held face-to-face for the first time since the pandemic struck. It's set on November 18 to 19 in Bangkok. A health reform advocate again calling on the Philippine government to tweak the definition of full vaccination. Dr. Tony Liachon says it should be done hand in hand with the further reopening of the economy, as he believes the Philippines is now living with the virus. Currently, being fully vaccinated means the person has received the primary vaccine doses.
In the next administration, the first 100 days, I think the marching orders for the Department of Health and all cabinet secretaries is to help all employees, all people. Though it's not a mandate, but to redefine it to 3 doses and have the vaccines ready for everybody, so that in the next 100 days you have full vaccination, 2 primary and then a first booster.
The Philippines' health chief claims the country has now contained the threat of COVID-19. Secretary Francisco Duque III said Wednesday daily cases did not see a spike despite mass gatherings during the election campaign season. But Duque still urges the public to remain cautious as the virus may further mutate.
So far, given our measures, our interventions, mukhang contained na siya, no? And the data will support that claim. But at the same time, we are realistic to accept the fact that this virus is notorious for mutations. It is capable of springing surprises at every turn.
Duque, meanwhile, rejected calls to shut borders amid the monkeypox threat. But he adds he has ordered strict monitoring and surveillance for the virus.
It is premature to be closing borders to travelers from these endemic areas. Ang utos ko last May 7 sa BOQ is to be very strict, to enforce strict screening standards, symptom screening. No? Galing sa mga endemic countries or non-endemic countries with risk of monkeypox, dapat alamin yung symptoms.
A group of medical workers wants President-elect Marcos to appoint a health chief who is pro-people. The Alliance of Health Workers also hopes the next head of the Department of Health has an excellent track record on good governance and has accountability and integrity. That call from the group comes as it expresses dismay over the allegedly anomalous pandemic supply deals between government and formerly pharmaceuticals. It believes the funding could have been better used to purchase medicines and provide benefits for healthcare workers.